Hey guys, and welcome back. Today we will be talking about one of the most requested things on the entire channel, how to play War Robots on PC properly, just like the way I do it in all my videos. However, I will also include some other possible ways to play the game on Windows as well. Now, the reason why I always held back onto making this video is because I wanted to find a stable way to play the game without having some sort of lag, and all the previous methods I had weren't just that good enough. And as this video will probably be the main source of info on this topic, I preferred to wait until I find some kind of an optimal setting within which I know that it will work for most of you guys. So before we start talking about anything, I want to make sure that you guys are familiar with this one basic idea. There are three different War Robots platforms that are completely separate from each other: iOS, Android, and Windows, respectively. The main idea is that you can't share your account between any of these platforms. Now, with that being said, we get to dive into the first method, playing using Windows dedicated app. So just a few months ago, Pixonic announced the official War Robots launch on Windows with its own separate servers. Now, just as we mentioned before, you won't be able to play using your actual Android or iOS account there. You will have to start from scratch. However, you will get the added benefit of outstanding game performance and twice as smoother gameplay compared to high-end Android and iOS devices, which is 60 frames per second compared to 30 on all other platforms. Now let's talk about how you can get the actual app. Go to Google and search Facebook Game Room application. You will also find the official site to download Game Room at the top of this video description. Just download it and then log in using your Facebook account. As Pixonic is in a partnership with Facebook, they decided to host their new Windows app inside the Game Room application. You could take this in a similar way to Steam and all other games hosted on Steam, which means that you must have a Facebook account to start having a War Robots profile on the new platform. It will be also required to load your game save from the cloud whenever you change the PC that you are using to play the game. Now, the Windows app comes pre-configured to give you the highest possible graphics and performance based on your PC available hardware. Thanks to that, you don't have to worry about tweaking the game settings and you can just head straight up into battle immediately. But with that being said, the downside is that you can't change the controls since they are also pre-configured as well. As someone like me who tried many different control schemes, I think the one that Pixonic is using on the Windows app is one that not many people will like on the long term. I did ask them to allow people to change their control scheme, but they just ignore me as usual. Anyway, I recommend you taking the previously mentioned method if you are still relatively new to the game, as when switching to the new platform, you won't have to lose a lot of progress. But with that being said, for those who are playing the game for more than a year, you are probably waiting for the next solution. Now we move to Android players and the current method I am using to emulate the Android system on my PC. But before I start, please notice that this method is for Android users only. If you are an iOS player, then I am very sorry for you, but there isn't any possible way to emulate the iOS system just like what we do with Android. You can go and thank Apple for this, as they keep their iOS system exclusive for their company alone, unlike the Android OS, which is basically a freeware for anyone to use. Now, in order to get started, we need to download the brand new Nox 5 Android emulator. It's still very new, but already surpasses all other emulators in terms of performance by a mile. You can get it by searching Nox emulator on Google, but I will also have a link for it at the top of the video description. Now, after having Nox downloaded and installed, you need to immediately configure its available resources alongside some other important stuff. Head to the settings panel at the top right of the emulator screen and enable root mod. We will need this one later, but for now, head to the advanced settings tab. Here we'll be assigning how many CPU cores and RAM the emulator is going to be using for the rest of its lifetime. Now, I need to emphasize on something. Not all PCs are able to run Android emulators properly. This is decided by the availability of minimum resources required that the emulator needs to have in order to operate without any issue or crashes. First off, if your PC doesn't have the minimum of 2 CPU cores, then you might as well just forget about this video to begin with. In general, you need 2 available at minimum to run the emulator without any crashes, although that's still likely to happen. And while using it to play games, you better make sure that all other background applications on Windows are closed, or you are going to have some hard time with all the upcoming emulator crashes. Now, if you don't know how many cores are available in your computer in the first place, head to your PC properties and go to Device Manager tab. There you will find a list called Processors. Click on it and count how many cores your PC has. The optimal amount of cores needed to run the emulator without any issues is 4 cores. If you have that amount available, assign them all to the emulator. And if it happens that your PC has even more available cores, then you might as well stop at 6. Android system is not well optimized for heavy multithreading like Windows, so giving it anything higher than that won't improve performance at all. It's actually the opposite, as if we force multiple cores into some unoptimized Android apps, this will cause them to crash very frequently. Now, for setting the RAM resource, that's much easier to decide compared to the CPU cores. You need to have 4 gigs of RAM minimum on your PC, and be sure never to give your emulator or the RAM available on your computer, or this will leave your Windows operating system with no memory to work with. The general idea is that if you have any amount of RAM memory below the 8 gigs, then you should assign 75% of it to the emulator. And if your PC has higher than that, then stop at 8 gigs, as this will provide all the possible required memory for the emulator to work with. Now, for setting the emulator screen resolution, be sure it's the same as the one assigned to your desktop. Mine is set to be around 4K, however you could still reduce that if your computer doesn't have a strong graphics card to handle it. And for the DPI setting, you should scale that well with the resolution selected. As it goes up, you will have to increase it accordingly. Finally, we get to change the most important option exclusively available in NUX 5. It checks the DirectX box in a state of Open Graphics Library, which stands for OpenGL, as this will enable your emulator to have better communication with your processor, which greatly increases performance up to 3 times more compared to other Android emulators out there. However, keep in mind that the DirectX system was never designed to be used by Android. If you start to face a lot of crashes, then you might as well switch back to OpenGL for more stability at the cost of the better optimization you get. Now, once you finish all of that, save your changes and restart the emulator. Once the emulator restarts, you can start using it just like how you'd use a normal Android device. Now go to the store and install War Robots. The next step is very important if you want to enable high-end in-game graphics like shadows and other environmental effects. To change that, you need to get an app called GL Tools from the store. Now, GL Tools isn't a freeware. It costs around 4 bucks, but you can still get it somewhere else from the internet if you can't buy it for whatever reason. And since I don't support piracy, I want to provide any illegitimate link for it in the description. You will have to find it yourself. Anyway, with that being said, having GL Tools is not necessarily important to run the game on the emulator. However, as it can be used to adjust the graphics and resources, that's useful to avoid some pre-assigned default game settings that might cause some infrequent crashes. Now, if you got the app installed, open it and check the second installation option, as well as check all the boxes at the bottom left of the screen. Then click on the install icon. Don't forget to allow the app to gain super user access if it asks for it, and then continue. The Android system will reboot, and this will allow GL Tools to gain access to the system files. After all of that finishes, you should be able to open GL Tools again, and this time you will see a list of installed apps on the Android system. Search for War Robots and open it, and then follow my steps. First of all, check Enable Custom Settings option for this app, as well as Optimized GLSL Shaders option. Next, go to GPU Name / Emulation tab and check the first 2 boxes at the top. Next, click on Template option. As you will notice, you have a plenty of options here. Select Adreno 530 fake GPU, 4 cores of CPU, and 4 gigs of RAM. If you don't have Adreno 530, you can go with the previous version, which is the Adreno 430. It will still do good and will give you the high-end graphics you need, which is exactly the same from what you will get from the 530 version. But that one is fairly more optimized. But since we are using the DirectX, as I have mentioned before, you won't be noticing any difference from using any of these two fake GPUs. Now everything I just mentioned above depends on whatever graphics card you have inside of your PC. Normally, Nvidia cards are fairly more optimized to work better with Nox emulator compared to AMD cards. So if you have an AMD card, you might get some dark graphics inside the game. This could be fixed by changing the fake GPU option we talked before, but if you try all of them and the problem still persists, then you will definitely have to update your graphics card driver software to the latest version before the problem gets fixed. So finally, after all of that, you can open WarRobot and load your Android save from the cloud using your Google Plus account. Then you can start a battle and enjoy the game with whatever controls you like to have. For my controls, I use the standard WASD virtual D-pad for moving my robots. I assign a spacebar for firing using the red button, and the numbers from 1 to 4 for firing each one of my weapons individually, respectively. And for screen rotation, I just click with my mouse on the screen and start moving left and right as needed. It's good to mention that you might want to change your mouse DPI settings in the control panel in order to have the perfect rotating speed inside the game to match your aiming speed. So this should be it for this tutorial. If you faced any issue, be sure to let me know in the comment and I will make sure to reply as fast as I can. So thanks you guys for watching, and I will see you in the next video.